everyone, it's John.
And Ryan.
And it's time for another Munch Pack opening on...
What's Ryan trying?
You know, we didn't hear back from the Munch Pack people last time about your jingle idea.
Oh, they did. They must be still running it through HR, I'm guessing.
But they still sent us a box, so...
They didn't hate it.
So let's see what's in the July box. They switched up the box a little bit this time. Look at all these smiley faces on it.
All the little Munch Pack treats inside. They're all happy.
And this month we are going to try the... We're going to try the Munch Pack scanner, where you scan the item and it tells you what it is, and you could buy it if you wanted to.
Okay, let's open up the box.
Ooh, good. This one's made with love by Chris.
Oh, look, we got some more panda.
Nice.
Oh, man, I love panda.
let's not go there again. This looks like it's strawberry panda, though.
Yeah, strawberry flavored panda meat. I like the milk flavored ones we had last time. Ooh, smells strawberry-y.
Okay, there's what it looks like.
Just like the other ones, only a little bit pink.
It's not bad. I think I like the milk ones from last time better.
I like this one pretty well, but it tastes like it should be a cereal.
Try some, Jenna.
I like those.
Okay, so next up, it looks like we have Atlantic Lobster Old Fashioned Kettle Cooked Potato Chips. They sound like something that would come from Maine.
I don't know. I wonder if they're any better than those crackers we tried.
I wonder if it's from Canada with a maple leaf on it.
Made in Canada. I feel like we're traders eating Canadian lobster.
Canadian lobster. Well, I don't know really where the border is.
All right. They don't really smell lobstery.
No, they don't.
Okay, here's what a lobster potato chip looks like.
Kind of smells like barbecue.
If I was expecting a lobster chip and I had a barbecue chip, I'd be sorely disappointed.
They don't really taste like lobster to me.
No, they taste like a regular old potato chip. I don't know, maybe...
I get more, like, salty, you know, that you would kind of get from lobster, like the salt water.
Maybe the lobster is just the mascot. It's not actually the flavor. Right.
Maybe. Well, is there a flavor on the front?
Lobster extract powder.
I don't taste lobster.
I don't taste much lobster. I get a hint of, like, sea salt.
Yeah.
But I don't get lobster.
Ingredients include russet potatoes, canola oil, lobster extract powder, spice, sea salt, dehydrated garlic, evaporated cane juice, hydrolyzed soy and corn protein, salt, and lemon oil. So there you go. You make some at home.
I wonder where they extract the lobster powder from.
They just shake the lobster like that.
Probably.
The powder comes
out. It's like
out.
A salt shaker.
All right, how about you pick the next one?
All right, let's go with this thing.
Like a big orange on it.
I am. Yeah, there's a little orange with a smiley face and some lettering that I don't understand. Oh, wait, that has a website. Yaokin.com.
Yaokin.com.
Is it an orange or a peach?
I think it's an orange.
Yeah,
looks orangey to me.
Oh, yeah, it does look like an orange.
So, yeah, if anybody knows in the comments where this originated from, let us know. Okay, so... It looks like a big single, like a Twizzler almost. Oh, I broke it. I broke it.
Maybe it comes in halves.
There we go. It smells very orangey.
Oh, yeah, it does. It smells... It's like orange zest.
Oh, that's good.
Pretty good. Very sweet. Very orangey.
It reminds me of those little gumdrops.
All right, so next up... Now, I wonder what this one tastes like. We've had... The past couple of months, remember we had one that tasted just like corn.
Mm-hmm.
And one that looked like a big Cheeto.
So this looks like a little spaceman.
Yeah, like an astronaut cat or something on the box. So, let's see. I have no idea what this one tastes like.
It's a little darker than the last one.
Looks like cinnamon.
Tomato powder is in here.
Okay, so it's probably not cinnamon.
Barbecue?
Maybe.
Alright, let's give it a try. I can never break these in half. Obviously, these are, like, intended for, like, one person. All right, Ryan, how about you just take a bite and I'll bite out the other half?
Oh, you're afraid it's going to, like, splinter into a million pieces? Tastes like tomatoes.
Mm, yeah, it tastes like tomatoes.
Ugh, tastes like tomato soup. Yeah, I don't like that.
I don't like that at all.
You don't think tomato soup flavored
no.
puffs would take off here?
No.
So what do we got here?
We've got sour snakes.
Those are some cool looking snakes. They're wearing their hats backwards.
They must be pretty cool. I think these are from Mexico. So you got a couple different colors here. We got green, pink, orange, and yellow. I don't know if they're all different flavors.
Look how small these snakes are.
They're more like little worm chunks.
Maggots.
Yeah.
Ew. Alright. I wonder how sour they are.
Pretty sour.
Are you regretting putting the whole thing in your mouth?
I took like a little tiny bite of this thing. It was super sour.
Oof.
I guess if I like sour things, it'd be pretty good.
So Ben and Jenna seem to like the sour snakes.
I'm not a big fan.
I don't really taste any sour in this.
What color did you have?
Green.
Oh, I had the orange.
Like, I don't feel any sour at all.
What is this?
Oh, it looks like...
It looks like there's multiple steps here.
Do you have to put it together?
Is it like some chocolate marshmallow, like a s'mores type
thing?
Yeah,
but I don't know what the green stuff is.
Can we see it?
Nope. It's got two little rabbits on the back.
All right, so it looks like... I don't know.
There are directions. You put them all into the tray.
Looks like we have to add water. All right, let's take a look here.
Oh, this is going to be pretty involved.
It's like a science project. Oh! So we got this, we have this little packet. I think this is the chocolate.
I don't know. I think this is the green stuff. It's a powder.
We're going to try to decipher this. Jenna, can you bring it? Oh, we have some water in here. Never mind. We can do this. It even comes with this little, like, fork thing.
Mm. Yeah.
So I scanned this on the Munch Pack app, and it says, a unique Japanese candy kit where you create sticky, maki candy dipped in chocolate and matcha kinako green tea soy powder. All you need to do is sprinkle water on the maki, which is pounded rice.
Oh, these.
Yep. Those things.
And they will soften up. Includes a fork for spearing and dipping. And there are easy picture instructions on a colorful Japanese package.
Okay, so here is the chocolate sauce. Look at that right there.
Mmm.
I guess now we need to sprinkle some water over this and or is it this that we have to sprinkle the water on?
I think it's
on?
The white things.
All you need to do is sprinkle water on the maki discs and they will soften up.
What it looks like is you dip it, you sprinkle it on those, dip it in the chocolate, and then dip it in the... In the green tea.
Okay, here we go.
Sprinkle.
I don't have a sprinkle bottle.
Well, you have a sports top. Okay.
There we go.
Oh, yeah,
they're really absorbing that water.
Let me try to zoom in.
I don't know if I'm gonna like the green tea thing.
Okay.
So we have these little rice patties, this green tea stuff, and chocolate. This sounds interesting, huh? All right, so I take one of these mushy discs.
No, they're sticky.
Oh my gosh! Yep, sprinkled a little too much water.
It's turning into one big disc.
Oh, it's so slimy. All right, here we go.
It's like a slug.
It's like a booger.
You should just eat it with your finger.
Okay, so do I do the chocolate first
or the
powder?
The chocolate first and then the powder.
Yeah, it looks like you got chocolate and then some of the green stuff on the top.
All right, so got some chocolate on there. And now I'm going to dip it in the green tea powder. Here we go. That's what it looks like. Doesn't it look appetizing?
Nope.
It looks fancy on this fork.
It does.
I feel very fancy.
Okay. Try it.
Down the hatch.
Down the hatch.
Surprisingly, that's not bad at all. I'm not a fan of the texture of these boogers. Booger patties.
The rice patties.
I'm going to have to touch all of them, I think.
You're doing it the American way, just ripping it apart.
Yep.
No dainty little fork for you.
Well, all right, let me use a little fork.
I made an effort not to slobber all over it.
Well, I appreciate that. That's pretty nice of you. Oh, my goodness, it's not easy.
Well, it's inching its way towards the chocolate.
Okay. The texture really throws me off, but it doesn't really taste that strong about anything, really.
I kind of want to try it.
Yeah, we want to try it. Is that enough?
Jenna's turn.
All I could taste was the chocolate.
That's all I can taste, too. But the texture is really, really weird.
Let's see, what do we have next?
Those look like little cookies of some sort.
Yeah, there's no barcode, there's no nothing on it. It's like, it's like maybe it fell out of Chris's lunchbox. He was in his shirt pocket when he was packaging something. Like, whoop.
So what is that?
I don't know, they look like little sugar cookies, but... I have no clue what that writing should be.
Let's hold it up to the camera. We're going to take a bite and then find out it was like hotel soap.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, here we go.
It's too bad it has nothing for a barcode, so if you loved it, you wouldn't even know how to get it.
Yeah, there's no ingredients, there's no country of origin.
It looks like a rice cake, I feel.
Mm. Oh, it smells bad.
Yeah. Sounds like maybe a shoe or something.
Yeah.
Alright, anyway. I don't know how to describe it. It's not horrible.
No, it's not good, though.
No.
And I only ate this much of it.
You know what that reminds me of? Like, in the stores, you can get, like, the rice crackers, like, mix.
This reminds me of, like, the white cheddar rice cake.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
All right, so next up we have Twins cream-filled wafers caramels. This is from Signature Snacks.
Oh, that looks pretty good.
And let's see. This is from, looks like, it says United Arab Emirates, and then it also says in association with United Products in Germany.
Hmm.
So let's see what we got here.
Oh, I expect them to be going the other way. They're little short guys.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Look at these little tiny wafer cookies. Oh, Ben can't wait. She doesn't even want us to try them first. Wait for us to try it. We're the ones on camera.
It smells a little bit like coffee.
Ooh, what's this one?
A wafer.
Mm, not bad.
Caramel, not bad. Right?
Yeah, mm-hmm. I like that.
Yeah, these are pretty tasty. I'll go back first.
Mm, they're very good.
Before they eat them all.
Hmm. Not really, really.
Thumbs up, Twins.
Mm-hmm. I think that one's going to be good.
All right, so next up we have Topper. Custard-flavored cream biscuits.
That sounds okay.
Best baked by bakers. Let's see, where did this come from? Australia.
Hmm.
All right, so let's give these a try.
I'm looking forward to this.
Well, these are interesting. I can't tell if they're just like, just so-so, or if I really kind of like them.
I wish the cream was a little thicker in the middle.
Mm. Yeah, I could see myself eating a whole sleeve of those.
Not bad.
But I do agree with Ben that I wish it was a little thicker on the cream, because it's kind of a dry cookie. Next up, we have Britannia date rolls. Have we had these before? I think we have.
We may have. They look a lot like Fig Newtons.
It may have been the same type of idea, but a different company.
Or from a different country.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so it looks like these came from India. We have a little bit of everything in this box this month.
A real global experience.
I feel so worldly. I know. I eat all this stuff.
Like, I just came back from a backpacking trip through Europe.
So let's see what these look like. They do look like. They look exactly like Fig Newtons. Maybe a little smaller.
Yeah. And a little drier looking.
Mm.
They're a little harder than a Fig Newton. Like, they have a little bit more cookie outside.
Mm. All right, last but not least, we have knife candy.
Does it look like a knife?
I don't know. That looks like a jackknife from here.
Where did this come from? It says China. Alright, so let's see what knife candy is all about.
In the U.S., you'd probably get a detention for bringing that to school. Oh, it's like a, butterfly knife.
Yeah, butterfly knife. That is awesome.
You would get suspended for sure for bringing that to school.
Mm-hmm.
That's a simulated weapon.
Wow.
It doesn't really smell like anything.
Looks like it's got apples, oranges, and I think there's apples and oranges on the front.
Well, since it's what's Ryan trying, I'll give you the first dibs on it.
How many licks does it take to get to the center?
One, two.
It's not bad. I licked this side if you want to lick the other side. Doesn't really taste like much to me.
No, it doesn't. I think probably the novelty is... Oh, no, I broke it.
Yeah.
I was going to... Uh-oh.
Yeah, I think it's all just because it looks like a knife.
Yeah, they could put any flavor of candy in there. And I just broke it already. There goes our endorsement from Knife Candy.
I know, I was hoping to ride that one all the way to the bank.
So quite a few winners out of this box. But what was your least favorite?
My least favorite was this thing, I think.
The tomato-flavored...
Corn roll. I should have known with the look on this astronaut's face that, you know, something bad was about to happen to him.
And I think the winner for the weirdest one was this little rice cake green tea chocolate thing.
Yeah, it looks like they've all started to dry out again.
Yeah, but that one wasn't as horrible as I thought it was going to be.
No, it wasn't horrible. It was just weird.
Yeah, it's just weird.
Well, if you've heard of any of these snacks before, be sure to let us know down in the comments. And a big thanks to Munch Pack for sending us another box full of goodies. Well, that wraps up another Munch Pack on What's Ryan Trying. If you like this video, be sure to subscribe to our channel and like and comment. And you can also follow Jenna and Ryan on their own YouTube channel.
Yeah, you can check out what we're doing at whatsryantrying.com.
We'll see you next time, everybody.
Bye.